Hey guys, welcome back to 1Fredjones Plays Minecraft. So in today's episode, I've decided we need to go to the Nether. I think it's the next logical thing to do. So I went ahead and I made a little staircase here. Obviously it's unfinished, but I want to get to the Nether, so I'm not going to waste any more time trying to pretty stuff up. We can do that later. So let's go ahead and get our portal built here. Now I'm going to make this one not the standard size. I mean, ever since they made it where you don't have to have one size portal, I've been ecstatic. I love it. So anyways, let's go. Let's see what's going on. Let's not die, hopefully. Achievement! Jeez Louise. Okay, what do we got? It'd be awesome if there's a fortress right here. No, at least we're out in the open. We didn't build it down too low. Okay, I don't see any fortress. Nether quartz, that's cool. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and tool around a little bit here, and I'll bring you guys back when I have found something. Alright guys, we're back and we found a fortress. So let's get down there and get in there and see what we can find. Hopefully we find a spawner, a blaze spawner. Already killed one blaze, you guys can see here, and I got the achievement in Tafaya. So, I think first, let's get some torches down. I hate these fortresses are so dark. Okay, let's go ahead and just go down here first. Get the nether rack. I mean, the nether rack. Get the nether warp. Oh, man, it goes down. This is, oh, a chest. Gotta get the chest. Nope, before we get the chest, let's get the nether warp before I forget. Oh, what was that? Oh, just a pigman. Alright, let's get the soul sand too while we're at it. One thing about being in a single player world, you don't have to worry about leaving any nether warp for the other guys. Let's grab it all. I mean, there have been servers that I've played on that people didn't care anyways, but we care. Okay, so let's go down here now and get our chest. Surely there's something awesome in this chest. Yeah, we got some more obsidian. Awesome. Oh, you know what? I guess it just occurred to me that if you didn't find a diamond, if you didn't find diamonds, and you made a portal with lava and water, you could very easily get to the Nether, find a fortress, get in a chest. You know what? Actually, let's get these chests. Get into a chest, find some obsidian, and make. Or let me rephrase all of that. If you only found two diamonds and were unable to make a diamond pickaxe, you could still make a portal, get to the Nether, get to a fortress, dead end, and so get to the Nether, find a fortress, and find the obsidian you needed to make an enchanting table. That's what I was trying to say. Do we look around here? There's got to be, yep, there normally is. Staircase going down the backside or something here. Man, it's so dark in here. Come on, spawner. No spawner. More wart. I might as well leave that there just in case something happens. Okay. I would love to find a spawner. Or three or four. Would it be cool if you found four all together? Be amazing. This thing is huge though. I'm gonna go ahead and tool around some more in here, and if I find anything cool, I'll bring you guys back. Aha, guys, I think I found a spawner. I know I found at least a blaze, but it looks like there's a spawner right there. Let's see what we need to do to get there. I wonder if they changed blaze AI like they changed the skeleton AI. Wouldn't surprise me. Oh, there another one? There is another one. There's the spawner right there. Yep. Okay. We gotta get out of there. Dang it. I was hoping that when we did find a spawner, it would be underground or under netherrack at least, you know? Crap. I don't have any arrows either. Oh, no. Oh, no. All right, guys. So I'm gonna have to kill these guys, man. I can't not kill these guys, right? out of here and eat. Ooh. Heal up a little bit. Go back and kill him. Some more. Oh, another one came out of the spawner. Crap. Get rid of that and that. Maybe I can lead him down here away from the spawner a little bit. Because when I go back through there, I just want to run through there. Ah, crap. I just want to run through there and not have to worry about fighting off any blaze. He might be far enough away. Come on, dude. Come back here. Oh, I thought I dodged it. Oh, there's another one there, too. Crap. Alright, I give up. Oh, I'm gonna die. Whew, that was a close call. Alright, I'm just gonna stay away from there, I guess. I'm gonna cruise around. Let's go down here real quick. See what's down here. Another spawner. This one is underground. Yes! Yes! Alright. Alright. I'm going to have to get some more blocks. I want to get netherrack blocks, so I don't want to use cobblestone. Whew. I don't know what I'll do with that other spawner, though. Maybe I'll just try to cover it up so it doesn't spawn. Yeah, I don't know. We'll worry about that later. That's stuff we can worry about later. All right, we got some blocks. Let's go block off the front of that spawner. Oh, let's eat first, too. Wow. All right. Now let's go block off the front of the spawner. Let's just do one of these jobs. Like that. Perfect. So now, if we need blaze rods for some reason, we can come over here and get them. I've got the six already, but cool. So I'm going to do some more exploring and see if there's anything else cool in here. So, guys, I had to get out of there. I don't know if you noticed, but I've only got 3 armor. If you look, all the thing I'm wearing right now is that stupid chest piece. So everything else got destroyed. I should have paid more attention. I was in such a hurry to get to the Nether and go check out stuff. I didn't even look at my armor. And I think most of it was already about damaged because we were in that cave last episode. And I think most of it got damaged there. But again, I didn't check to see what kind of shape it was in. And we don't have any armor. So let's go ahead and get some glowstone. And then I want to make a portal for fast travel over to that abandoned mine shaft. So let me get all this glowstone right here, and then we'll go make a portal. Alright, guys, so I went ahead and got the area set up in the Nether for our portal to the abandoned mine shaft, and then I came back to the base to get geared up. I got all of our armor again and some arrows. So I wish I would have done that before we went to the Nether originally, but it's no big deal. Come back. Get suited and booted, and then go back. So let me show you where the portal is going to be. So in the overworld, it's 1,000 blocks away from the mining base. So in the Nether, it's only 222 blocks, I think. So this is going to make it a lot easier to get back and forth from the abandoned mineshaft. And then when we get in there, I'll show you guys why I want to get back and forth between the abandoned mineshaft. Okay, so light it up. There we are. Okay, and you can clearly see why I want to get back and forth to the abandoned mineshaft. So after I quit recording last episode, I went down into the caves in this abandoned mineshaft all the caves that branched off of this guy. So there's a bunch of them. I'll just kind of show you real quick. Like, there's one right there, and then you branch off down that direction. I did all that, and then whenever I was getting ready to leave, I came up probably up through here, and I noticed that I had missed this part of the abandoned mineshaft. So I cruised over here to check it out, and to my surprise, found this spider spawner. So we have a way to quickly get XP. I know I found those blaze spawners in the Nether, but this is going to be simpler to build, number one, and number two, it's going to be easier to get to. So while we're working on the blaze spawners in the Nether, I can knock this out real quick. And as a matter of fact, we're going to get started on that in this episode. We got a little bit of time left in this episode, so I'm going to go ahead and start working on this. Be right back. Okay, I think I'm at the point now where I'm ready to test this thing. Let me show you what we got going on, though, first. So, here's our spawner. I already hooked up the lights. And this guy is basically in a 9x9 room. And then the spiders are going to get washed down that direction, down underneath here. Now, spider spawners, or spiders in general, are the hardest mob to move around in this game, in my opinion. Blazer, of course, pretty difficult. You can't use water in the Nether, stuff like that. But these guys, I think, are honestly worse. They don't like to go where you tell them to go. They fight water currents more than any other mob does. And they like to cling to walls. Of course, you know, zombies and skeletons, creepers, stuff like that. They're not going to grab a hold of the wall. These guys do. So it's going to take probably some ironing out to get this figured out exactly how we want to do it. They change the AI every time they do an update. So the 1.7 spiders don't act the same way as the 1.8. And the 1.8 are not acting the same way as the 1.9. So we're going to try to figure this guy out. But let's look around a minute. Got our lights going. That's good. See, where's that? Got some. Oh, I don't need no blocks. So the light is pretty easy. I got a little lever right here powering this redstone. Goes around to that light there. Then there's a light here. A light here. And a light over here. Now, it's super easy to wire these lights up. There's no reason why people shouldn't do this. I was watching a video, doing a little research on the 1.9 spider AI. And the guy who was doing the video was like, I don't know why people light up their spawners. It's the easiest thing in the world to do. You can turn it on, turn it off. So, anyways, let's go ahead and get busy here. What we're going to do to start is go ahead and put our water in. Let's do that. Now we're going to put water all the way across the back wall here. Start with that one. And then put water right next. Oh, that one. Come on. I hate water. Okay, let's go right there. And we can finish filling this guy out. Now, it took me a little bit to do the math and to figure out exactly how much or how far everything was going to go, but I think I got it, and I did. All right, awesome. So let's do this. I want to be able to see these spiders whenever they come into that area right there, mainly because I want to see if they're getting stuck on these blocks right here, and I'm sure they're going to. But okay, let's see. I got some blocks, so let's go put regular blocks on here. I'll change these out later, make it look good, but for right now let's just use cobblestone like that. And then let's put glass in. I need to put one in right there. Oh man, can I reach it? I can. Okay, so yeah, I don't think we'll check here in a second to see how much light from this side is getting into the spawning area. Shouldn't be too much. Let's go see. The light doesn't matter once these guys spawn. Alright, can't tell. Gotta shut the stupid thing off. Let's shut it off. Let's get our fence post. Something else these guys do is they can get you from like this far away. So, like, if there are spiders right here underneath that fence post, if you're standing, like, this far back, you can still get hit. So that's something we're going to have to iron out for sure. Oh, shut the light off. Shut the light off. Now let's see how much light's getting in there. Can't be too much. Those guys spawned right away. Can you hear them? There's a little bit getting in there. I don't know if it's really going to affect anything. Let's block this side in. Oh, look at that. Three of them spawned. Yeah, the most a spawner can spawn, if you don't know, is four at one time. So, let's see. See if they're getting stuck. See what they're doing. They're kind of stuck, aren't they? All right, let's let a few more spawn and see what happens. I'm guessing that when more come in, they'll push the other guys down the tube. Yeah, they're not wanting to go into that one by area. Come on, guys. It's almost like they make it harder and harder for you to get a cave spider spawner to work. So every update, they change something. Now, one thing about the 1.7 update is these guys would follow you through walls. So if you were standing back over here by the fence post, these guys would try to get to you. But that's not the case anymore. They'd use their own AI against them. Okay. Well, I'm going to sit here a little bit, and I'll bring you guys back in a minute. Alright, guys. Well, it looks like it's working okay. It's not working perfectly, but it's working okay. These guys do tend to get backed up from time to time into a little bottleneck right here. But as more spiders come down into here, it actually causes these ones that are making the bottleneck to flow through. So let's see, we've got about 74 right there, and then 30 over here. So you see there's like two right there in that corner, at least two, maybe three. There's at least two right there, so on and so forth. There are a ton of spiders in here. And then something else that I was kind of concerned about, but I don't think it's anything to worry about, is that in one version of the game, you had to move your spawns, I don't know, like 17 blocks away from, they had to be outside the 16 block area that the player had to be inside in order for the spawner to continue spawning whatever it may be. So I don't think that's the issue now, because we're only, I think that block right there is only 15 away from the spawner, and they're still spawning, still coming in good. Again, let's look one more time. 82 now in there. Oops. And then let's go see. Let's look at it. Let's turn the light on and then look at it from the backside over here. This is where I like to go to look inside there. Yeah, see, we don't have. Oh, there's one that climbed up. And one reason why I built that the way I did is I made that wall further that direction is so that not very many of these guys will be able to climb up. So I think it looks pretty good. I may just leave it the way it is, honestly. I was starting to think that we might have to make some changes at first because they were bottling up so bad right in here. But let's go ahead and turn this back on. Let's watch to see if we can see another spawn. Watch it just for a second or so, see if they'll spawn. Go, go. Oh, yep, they're still spawning. I don't know if they're spawning quite as fast as they were in the beginning, but still, no issue. Okay. So now we need to make a... Oh, those look so cool. We need to make a crusher. So let's turn this light on. Although, I don't think I'm going to build the crusher in this episode. It may just be something we work on later on. I turned the hostile mob sounds down. These spiders were driving me nuts. Yeah, it might be something I just work on my own and show you guys what I came up with. I honestly thought for a minute that I would make this area right here the killing chamber, because they are all bottling up right here. I thought I'd run a fence post from there all the way across to here and use that, but you wouldn't be able to crush them very easily. I mean, I bet we could figure out a way to do it, but it'd be so much easier like this. Oh, look at all that XP. Heck yeah, buddy. Heck. Oh, see, I told you they can get you from a mile away. Jerks, oh, he got me from down there. Come on, dude. Ah. No. I want to kill that guy before I end the episode. Die, dude, die. Oh, he died. Alright, guys. Well, oh, more XP. I love it. Look at it, it's coming. no more trying to kill pigs and breed cows to get XP. I love it. Okay, guys. Well, I appreciate everybody watching. Tune in next time.